we are given our last horned grain. We will not see another sunrise unless one of us grows coward and does not and cowardly crawls to his to the Lord to beg for Ruth. The bird is breech, and bitten too often our briny sound empty, leaving our breasts open to many cold bones. I see around me blood in every form and death at every size, and health is not blooming. So take from your arms the rings that you got from your lord in goodlier days, and wrap them around your hand to give weight to your blows. In weal and woe, we uphold our lord's honor. Let death itself run away from our shouts, because one thing outlives everything. Under the mold, everything goes, but high under heaven, the hero is held forever. Hofbrocky died. His men died. All was left was listen, short man called Hofi Chin. At Yasso, the queen and her husband, Hodgar, said to him, take my ring of gold, be my thane, prove to the world that I am as good as Hofi. Swear now to me. And the wizard, little man, came up and he said, that's not the way we did it with Hofi. What we did is he would give us his knife, his sword, and we would swear upon the hilt of it. So Thorgrim gives him the sword, and when he is not, he thinks that he will have the fate of at least one of Hofi's men. But this wizard, little man, takes that sword and places it in the gut of Thorgrim. No man can be a great thane unless he has the honor